Diego Rodriguez has a question. Diego asks, please, could you talk a bit more about spring preload and droop? So Diego's asking a little bit more about what we're talking about, the coilovers. So the spring preload is what we are adjusting when we compress the spring. So if I was to wind the spring perch up so much that it came into contact with the top mount and kept winding up and up and up, obviously the damper itself has got a mechanical lockout. It can't extend any further. So if I'm going to continue winding this collar up, that's going to put a preload on that spring. It's going to compress it. So that means that statically, before I've even put this thing in the car, there is a force inside the spring. So the important thing to understand that once you put this in the car and the car gets settled back down on the ground, that spring preload is going to be overcome straight away, and the damper isn't going to be topped out. It's going to be sitting at some partially compressed position depending on the stiffness of your spring and how much travel you've got, all that sort of stuff. But the important thing to understand is that that spring preload does not change the stiffness. Now Diego's asked about how that relates to droop. So the droop is really comes down to that lower collar adjustment that I was talking about before. So, well, it's in part of where you set your spring collar, but the idea here is that you want to, you've got that suspension travel range, you want to reserve around about a third of it for your droop and two thirds of it for your compression. So if that's our suspension travel, when the car's sitting at our ride height position, which we measured as I talked through in the example earlier, you want this position of the damper, if that's our maximum travel, if you, whatever your approximate one third position, we want it sitting about there. And the idea here is that we want to allow some droop travel. So as the car rolls, obviously the outside suspensions are going to become compressed as you transfer weight to the outside. The inside tires, while they don't have as dominant influence on the handling of the car as the outside tires, they absolutely still have a really relevant part to play as far as the lateral dynamics of the car, just giving you more grip. So the problem is if you don't allow enough droop travel as the car rolls, you want either your inside, your outside wheel will come off the ground. Now that's not necessarily a bad thing. There's lots of situations where having one wheel off the ground ends up being the fastest way to go around the corner. But what you don't want to do is prematurely limit your droop too much. So you always want some droop travel to allow, as the car rolls, that the tire still has the chance to contact the ground as you're entering the corner, because it does have, that inside tire, particularly in the front, does have a really big impact on the amount of grip you generate at the front of the car and the rear of the car. Having the rear inside tire come off the ground too early can be quite unsettling, and it gives you quite a low stability margin on corner entry. So that's why it's really important to, when you set your combination of your ride heights and your lower mount, you want to make sure that you are allowing a sufficient amount of droop travel at each end of the car to make sure that you don't prematurely end up lifting one wheel off the ground. If you like free stuff and you'd like to learn more about optimizing the performance and handling of your car on the racetrack, as well as improving your skills behind the wheel, then we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description of this video to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You're guaranteed to learn a lot, and you'll have a chance to ask questions which we'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so click the link to claim your spot.